Hi, in this video we're going to talk about how to use your graphing calculator to find probability between two values of a normal distribution. So this goes with section 6.2 in the notes. So here we see some directions. So to get to the normal distribution on the calculator, of course turn it on, you're going to hit second and then the vars button. You'll see above it says D-I-S-T-R, that's for distribution. So we're going to hit second vars, and then the one we want to use is this number 2 that says normal CDF, so you'll always choose that. Now, if you have an 83, this will already go back to the home page, and if it's an 84, you'll see something like this. Now, if it's between two values, two numbers, say from A to B, then you'll put the number A in lower, the number B in upper. You can just leave mu and sigma on 1, and then you'll come down here and hit paste. Okay, so we'll do examples of these in a minute. If it's something where you want all the values less than a number, you want a really big number, a really big negative number for the lower. So we can always put in something like negative 1,000. And then you'd go up to whatever your upper value would be, that A value. And if you want X is greater than some A, you'll put that A in your lower, and you'll use a big number for the upper, like 1,000. And this is for the standard normal. If you have a non-standard normal, you can change the mu and the sigma, and it'll do it for you. So this is the problem about the clocks. So this is a standard normal, so our mu is going to be on 0, our sigma is going to be on 1. And this first problem says, what's the probability that a single clock, if we choose it, will be more than 1.5 seconds slow? So more than 1.5 seconds slow. Remember, slow we consider to be negative, so negative 1.5, and we want everything that's more slow than that. So we're going to the left. We want everything less than negative 1.5. So we're going to hit second vars, number 2. Okay, now since this is a less than, we're going to put negative 1,000 here. And we're going to put negative 1.5, we're going up to negative 1.5. Since this is the standard normal, we'll leave these alone and we'll hit paste. Okay, so this is going to bring you back here to the home screen. Now, if you just have an 83, it would have brought you to the home screen with normal CDF, and you would have typed in negative 1,000, comma, negative 1.5. Okay? Now, the 0 and 1 is actually unnecessary. You can actually just close the parentheses and hit enter, or you can leave it there. And here we see that we get about 0.067 if we round to 3 decimal places. Okay, so now if we want to do a more than problem, here we want to know, what's the probability that it will be running more than 1.83 seconds fast after 24 hours? So again, we'll hit second distribution and choose number 2. Okay, here we want to go from 1.83 to the right. So our lower is 1.83. And then we want to pick a big number, like 1,000. You can make it bigger. 1,000 will do what we need, though. This is still standard normal, so we're going to leave 0 and 1. If you had a non-standard distribution, you could change your mu and your sigma. Okay, then paste, and then all we have to do is hit enter. Again, if you have an 83, you'll just put, it'll bring you to the home screen, you'll have normal CDF, parentheses 1.83, comma 1,000, close your parentheses. Okay, so here we get 0.034 if we round to 3 decimal places. And then finally, the other kind is if you're between two values. So here we want to know, what's the probability a clock will be running between 0.5 seconds and 1.4 seconds fast. So second vars normal CDF. Okay, so here our lower is 0.5, our upper is 1.4. This is still the standard normal, so we'll leave those. And here we get 0.228. Okay. Now, the same thing can be used for a non-standard normal. If you have a non-standard normal distribution, You would do normal CDF, and you would just change what your mu and your sigma are. Now, for if you have an 83, you would need to change them inside the parentheses. You would put whatever number, your lower bound, your upper bound, comma, your mean, and then your standard deviation. Or the other way you can do it is just do normal CDF and then put in your lower z-score and your upper z-score and close it. Okay, so if you do it with z-scores, you don't need to put in the mu and the sigma.